So we monitor fish to get an idea of distribution, so we have an idea of where habitat restoration actions could take place. So we'll go in and sample fish populations prior to habitat restoration actions and after to see which habitat restoration actions best influence these fish populations. So moving forward, we'll use those restoration efforts. And so we'll monitor those reaches prior to habitat restoration and after, so we can see how that influenced the fish species.
And so by doing habitat restoration, we directly affect, we increase the carrying capacity of the freshwater habitat so that we can get more smolts per female than we see now. And we're able to know that because Idaho Fish and Game and its partners have a wonderful monitoring network set up. We do red counts, we do carcass surveys, we estimate those numbers of adults, and then we also have screw traps. And we have other ways to monitor and enumerate those juveniles. And we know that relationship could be better by improving the habitat.
And there's also beaver dam analogs out here to create better quality habitat. So we're out here just trying to capture fish, put pit tags in fish, look at their distribution throughout the tributary, as well as what habitat types they're using, seeing if these BDAs, beaver dam analogs, have been working well or not. So we're interested in the distribution, the composition of fish, productivity, production. So we're looking at fish in, fish out. So how many adults are escaping? How many are coming to the Lemhi? How many fish are they producing? Are those fish surviving? Are they making it out of the Lemhi? And will they return?
Let's effectively monitor those actions, but then also let's also develop tools and products that we can apply to other areas. That was the big picture of the monitoring.
As far as the fish presence, that's where we rely on the regional fish biologists, and they'll monitor projects to see how we improved it over the years. And they're really helping. It's a good feedback cycle, so they help provide that feedback of where the projects really were successful and really evaluating the effectiveness of what we did.
We've already come in and looked at what fish are here, and we've seen an immediate and pretty dramatic response as far as the species, the numbers, and the life stages. There's other things we're learning too. I've been focusing on the anadromous fish, the listed ESA listed fish, but we're also learning a lot about our native resident freshwater resident fish, cutthroat trout, rainbow trout, and you know it's neat to see how those fish use this whole system in their life cycle.
I'm really excited to see how all the habitat restoration projects, how they might influence our population. Are we going to have better habitat capacity, which then creates more fish, larger fish, and then we have higher return rates and we can meet our recovery goals? So that'd be really exciting to look forward into the future and see if that happens.
So it's a kind of an adaptive management strategy where the information we're getting as far as our monitoring is really driving and fueling some of the project work we're doing on the ground. And that's, to me, that's the most important and most valuable piece of or valuable aspect of that information.
It's really, really exciting to see what we've done on the ground, have good solid science behind post-implementation to say this is what the response we see, and maybe this is the response we haven't seen. We've already used some of the data and the research to essentially design and construct different treatments, and that's really exciting. And as we move forward, let's see how we've done. If we see that we need to tweak it, let's tweak it. That's a really, really exciting part of this program as well that I really enjoy and I look forward to moving forward.